and this here may be tough to you. Snack cake to me, yeah, more hosts.
All hosts.
This been overdue forever. Asked me when it was dropping, said never.
Never.
Should've made you cut the feather, but I designed it Freemason Margiela.
What's goody, Shell Tron here, the most woke, no joking. I'm back at again with a brand new video, and I'm gonna keep it a bow, Barry Biscuit, man. This game was extremely impressive. I'm talking about the game, the Dolphins versus the Panthers, our second week of the preseason, and I saw a lot of things in this game that I wanted to either confirm from the last game versus the Bills, or I wanted to see improved from that Bills game. Now, there were some things that I saw that we continue to need to have work on, but I think the things that we didn't do well in this game were far outshadowed by the things that we did do well, and it wasn't just the first team that did really well. The second team did good. The third team, those other guys, those last few guys, did really well late in the fourth quarter. I think I'm starting this video with like 30 seconds, maybe a minute left in the fourth quarter, but there's nothing really going on right now. So I want to get in this video. I want to go ahead and get to the main points of this video. You know, in the Bills game, one of the biggest stories happened before the first snap, before even the first kickoff even happened. Kind of the same thing here, except it wasn't that big of a drama-filled thing, except for, like, you know, the reporters and, like, the Panthers.com guys, you know, Bill Voth, Max Henson, making a big deal of, ooh, will there be a midfield logo reveal, or, oh no, we see David Tepper walking toward midfield, is he gonna put the logo there himself? Is he gonna slap down a sticker, a 50-foot sticker of the Panthers logo on midfield himself? Camera zooms out, there's no actual logo, NFL or Panthers logo, or anything otherwise on the 50-yard line. But even though we weren't treated to seeing the actual Panthers logo on the field, we saw a lot of really good Panthers football on the field. Now, we did have a kind of a slow start to the game, and Ryan Tannehill was really dotting us up to start off the game. He was targeting Dante Jackson a little bit. We saw a lot of different things happening. Short, quick passes were really what they were going for. We were playing really off the ball. I think what we were trying to do with Eric Washington was we were trying to make sure that we weren't getting beat deep. Not on the beginning of the Bills game, we were getting beat deep by all their receivers. But since the Dolphins 1 and 2 receivers weren't in the game, there wasn't really a big chance of that happening early. But we still had our guys pushed back off the line a little bit. We were playing a lot of cover 3 when we were playing zone, with Mike Adams back when he wasn't playing in the nickel. We saw a lot of different guys playing the nickel today. And we saw that nickel blitzing a lot, which I said we should probably try out doing. But that nickel really got picked up most of the time in this game. We didn't see him get free a lot, but I think in the regular season, if we do blitz that nickel, we have to see what we can do about getting our front four to get pressure. Because if we had that nickel blitzing, that means someone on the line is going to have one-on-one coverage and blocking, and either that or the running back's going to already have someone to try to at least nudge a little bit. So we're going to see a lot of good things out of that if we have our nickel blitzing in the regular season. I don't really want to get into numbers for the preseason, because the preseason isn't about numbers. The preseason is about performance. Because you all know that, you know, Christian McCaffrey had 120 yards on the ground, one touchdown, averaged 13.3 yards per carry, which was really capped off with that 71-yard touchdown this man had out of nowhere. I think, yeah, he caught the first pass of the game, the first play of the game, and the second play of the game, he ran through between the tackles, and that was a really big play. Now, we know we want to give a lot of the onus on Christian McCaffrey, but you really need to tip your cap to Van Roten for pulling from the left guard position and really sealing that hole, opening it up for him in the tackle position, and he really took out two guys. He got Christian McCaffrey a really good lane there, and then from there, it was all about speed, and there ain't many guys on very many teams on defense who are going to catch Christian McCaffrey in a foot race. We saw it from his years at Stanford. You ain't going to catch this man out in space. Once he's out there, you got to pray he trips, or, you know, Mike Tomlin's out there with a little, you know, yeah, get his foot out there on the sideline, because it ain't just going to happen. But something else that was really interesting to see on offense was Cam Newton staying in the pocket. Now, the Dolphins, for some odd reason, didn't spy Cam at all. There was hardly ever a spy on Cam, and there was sometimes when there was a lot of good coverage downfield, and there was some wide open real estate for Cam to just rush through and have a really good at least 10-yard gain. I think I counted at least 3 plays early on in the first quarter where Cam had a really good opportunity to just take off, leave the pocket, and get a good gain with his legs. But it seemed like the game plan was to make sure he stayed in the pocket, go through all of his reads, all his progressions, and see what he can do in the pocket. Because you know he can run, but it's the preseason. You want to see things happening. You want to see what you can do and test things out for your offense. And where we did that, you know, when we got a touchdown from Christian McCaffrey, we went for 2. Didn't make it, but we wanted to see what we can do in goal line formation and what we can do in those short yardage and 2-point conversion situations. It seemed like the Dolphins were kind of scared to do really anything at all. They had their first four scores were field goals, and they could have gone for it on fourth down a few times, but they really chose to take the scared way out. I don't want to say anything bad about their play calling or about their coaching from Adam Gase, but I will say that it's the preseason. No one really cares too much about, you know, make the right play, or, you know, fourth down, what about field position? You want to see, it's all about testing. You don't care. I don't care if we would have lost this game by 10 or by 15. The thing you want to do is test and see what you have on the field from your players. And it seemed like the Dolphins did not want to do that with their guys. They wanted to play the safe way, which didn't really work out in their favor in this game. I just got the notification that we just won 20-27. Good for us. 2-0 in the preseason. Pat on the back. Good job, guys. We did well. Now, Cersei gets a helmet-to-helmet penalty early on in the game and gets shaken up, which honestly goes to show that maybe that rule about helmet-to-helmet hits and lowering the helmet has a good place in the game. Now, you know we're talking about, you know, oh, it's not football anymore, oh, you're penalizing physicality and all this other stuff, but there may be a good reason for why this rule is now in play in the NFL, because we just might have one of our guys in the secondary go down right now, and that's one of the biggest things we don't need right now for the Panthers. And like I said, the Dolphins and Ryan Tannehill were really cutting up our pass defense to start off with. We're running a lot of man in cover three, which kind of goes away from our usual Tampa 2 type of defense that we run. But I think that Ron Rivera wanted to see exactly what our young corners and safeties could really do, see what we can do with the nickel, and see what we can do when we go up against, mid-tier receivers. But what I will say is our run defense allowed nothing. Our first team run defense didn't allow anything. Second team run defense didn't allow anything. Now, their quarterbacks got a little bit of good percentages. I think, what was it? Ryan Tannehill went 14 for 17 for 100 yards. Brock Osweiler went 10 for 13 for 68 yards. Bryce Petty went 5 for 6 for 58 yards. And like I said, numbers don't really matter. But, you know, getting a lot of completions, that's a good completion rate. But did they do anything with it? We proved that. I think what we're trying to do this year is with our coverage being so lackluster, to say the least, it looks like we're adopting a bend but don't break New England style of defense this year, where, look, front seven, get what you can, and secondary, make sure no one gets past you. Look, the biggest thing is make sure there's no explosive plays, keep everything in front of you, and we'll make it work. If they get 3 points, good. We just need our offense to limit mistakes and be explosive from time to time, which is what we've really been great at the last few years. We haven't been a really consistent offense, but we're really explosive from plays from either Cam or in the passing game this year. The passing game this year is going to be amazing. We saw Demir Byrd have some good plays. Curtis Samuel on the sideline had a lot of really good plays. Torrey Smith on a comeback route. Remember what I said about Demir Byrd in training camp with those comeback routes with his speed? You have to respect his speed. And that comeback route, when he gives you that look and he starts chopping and comes back to the ball, that can be both his and Torrey Smith's bread and butter this year, because they both have blazing speed, and corners and safeties are going to have to really respect that speed. And when they come back on you or run an out route on you, and they make that really good cut, you have to respect the deep ball, so you can get caught off guard from time to time. And I really think that Torrey Smith and Demir Byrd can really make those two plays their bread and butter this year to cut up and really make Cam have a really good target for passes this year. We saw a lot of good things from our offense, but also some bad. And really the only bad thing I saw from our O was Matt Khalil can't block. He still can't block, man. It looked like the Dolphins' game plan was to hope and pray their secondary could do something. And if that didn't work out, just rush more than one person on the right side of the line and let Matt Khalil prove that not much has really changed since last year. Now, I'm holding out hope that we can get something from him later on in the regular season, but it's not looking too good, man. We have all these tributes and things for Ryan Khalil, but Matt's really proven that we still have something to worry about. Despite all the media stuff about, okay, he's coming back, he's not on, like, rehab, he's training. You know how rehabbing and training are two different types of mindsets and progression levels in the offseason. But it's looking like we're seeing a lot of the same things from Matt Khalil. We need to see a little bit more from him. I know you guys were commenting on my last video saying, oh man, Shelton, you've been really hard on the O-line, but tell me what you guys saw from Matt Khalil this game. Everyone else was doing good. Van Rutten was doing nice. I saw a lot of good things from a lot of other guys out there. But Matt Khalil really has me worried. And that outside position, for those outside runs and for that pocket presence on the outside, we really need that to be solid for Cam. Now we saw Ian Thomas. Ian Thomas had a crazy, 27-yard touchdown on a drag route. He was not even touched. Ian Thomas is 100% going to be a big factor. And Marquise Haynes had a really nice sack on Brock Osweiler. He's so fast. He's so agile. He can make that move happen. We saw some good things from TJ Anderson. Not really explosive plays, but good solid work from him. Cameron Artis Payne got a touchdown, but what we saw from him was really only decent. Nothing really super impressive out of him. I think he had, 18 yards, 8 carries. Look, you guys are really high on Cap still. Convince me. Tell him to convince me. He'll make the team, I think, still. But I'm not 100% convinced on him yet. I'm not sold on Cap just yet. But I'm still really impressed with the offense because the Dolphins brought a lot of different blitzes. They brought a lot of crash blitzes. They brought a lot of high pressure, pressure from the safeties, the corners, from linebackers, each and every way, from all of our stages of offense, from our first team, our second team, and we picked up those blitzes pretty well. Our quarterbacks were staying in the pocket, making plays. Taylor Heinicke has some of the craziest, he's so aware, he has such a good rapport with Curtis Samuel and Demir Byrd. It's wild for this guy to be this dialed in. Sick game of the preseason. I'm really excited to see how Taylor Heinicke really does play. We'll see more of Garrett Gilbert next week probably, or maybe in the fourth week against the Steelers, but I'm very impressed with Taylor Heinicke this week. Corn Elder with a really good double tip pick. Did you guys see that? I wish I could show a video on this and wouldn't get copyright striked, but Corn Elder tipped the ball 2 different times, caught it for an interception. This man is making sure. Look, he said, coach, come here. You saw me on the, you put me at number 6 on the depth chart. Here's why I should maybe be starting. Here's why I should probably be, you know, up there a little bit more. Push me up in that depth chart, coach. You need to see more from me. Elijah Hood and Kenyon Barner, if they don't make the team here, they may have made a team somewhere else. Some other team might be picking up the phone like, hold up, Panthers, who are those guys, Kenyon Barner and Elijah Hood? Can we talk to those guys? Maybe, please. I'm really thinking that we made a really good impression. I think we really proved that we're a pretty decent, well-rounded team at a lot of different positions, and I think we can really make a move here. But what do you guys see, man? Let me know in the comments below. But what do you guys see, man? Let me know in the comments below. And you already know to do that like button. Cheers to you, appreciate the chance. Being told y'all I've been the man. Being told y'all I had the gift. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Real ones gonna recommend. Count this as another win.